our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car, ready for the next race weekend. And we've got an issue we'd like your input on. The department wants me to pass on their thanks for helping out.
They told you about the new parts that have come in. Okay, your goal is to get through as many corner gates as quickly and precisely as possible. Best of luck out there. DRS zone is coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, Norris, and Max Verstappen. And that's...
Bad luck today. That must be incredibly disappointing. What caused that issue in practice? A new component? How do you feel this season is going for you? Is the car competitive? Appreciate your time.
We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. Just put in the fastest lap. Good job. Car repairs have set us back a little. That's the fastest lap so far. Well done.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. The owner driver, Bottas, and Lewis Hamilton. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. It's always good to qualify at the front, isn't it? You didn't practice much this weekend. Are you saving your car for the race? Great. Well, that's everything.
All right, I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
A warm welcome to all of you watching at home to today's Azerbaijan Grand Prix, and a race that in its short history has already proven no stranger to drama. A fourth row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as a pole position would. And remember, in 2017 and 2018, both Lance Stroll and then Sergio Perez took surprise podiums here. The Baku City Circuit measures roughly 6 kilometers and is made up of 20 corners and 2 DRS zones. The circuit winds around the narrow city, through the old town, and even brushes against the city's medieval walls. However, as beautiful as the setting is, this track is also a ferocious technical challenge, where the smallest of mistakes could lead to catastrophic consequences for all of our drivers. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. It's the owner driver in pole position then, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Sergio Perez, and Norris, Ricciardo, Leclerc, Sainz, and Pierre Gasly, Vettel, Fernando Alonso, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Tsunoda. Stroll, Ocon, Kimi Raikkonen, and George Russell, Armstrong, Mick Schumacher, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Thank you. confirmed. We'll receive you at the end of this lap. Box, we're coming in this lap. Are you all right? Engine off, engine off.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. So Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. So, let's review the driver's standings. A result that will make Sergio Perez happy as he pushes his championship lead out even further. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Yuki Tsunoda gets my vote today.
Let's move on to the constructors. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, Alpine move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Bad luck, Sadie. That must be incredibly disappointing.
You left a lot of paint on the walls today. Were you struggling for grip, or did you just misjudge some corners? Your teammate beat you today. Was it a setup issue or something else? Not a great day for your teammate today. What do you think went wrong? Great. Well, that's everything.